Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today's headline, Meghan Markle's snap. Was this the real reason Meghan wasn't allowed her wedding tiara? Meghan Markle stunned as a royal bride when she married Prince Harry last year. Alongside the royal wedding dress, the tiara for the big day was the subject of much speculation before the now Duchess of Sussex walked down the aisle. After the big day, sources suggested that Meghan had her heart set on a dramatic emerald tiara, the Vladimir Kokoschnik. It was the center of much controversy when it was reported that the Queen intervened after Harry declared what Meghan wants, Meghan gets. The Sun reported that the Queen told her grandson, "She gets what tiara she's given by me." The Queen's own wedding tiara, alongside Lady Diana Spencer, Sarah Ferguson's, and Sophie Rhys-Jones, have all been solely made from diamonds. Added to this, Meghan's closest royal relative in the palace hierarchy, Kate Middleton, wore a very delicate diamond scroll tiara for her royal wedding to Prince William. Another royal source just after the Sussex wedding suggested there had been concerns over the provenance of the tiara. Although the history of the Vladimir tiara is certainly dramatic, its provenance is in fact known. The beautiful Kokoschnik-style tiara, which comes from traditional Russian dress, was made in Russia in the late 19th century for Duchess Mary of Mecklenburg-Schwerin when she married Grand Duke Vladimir Alexandrovich, the third son of Alexander of Russia. The Duchess can be seen wearing the tiara with pearls instead of the more modern emeralds in many portraits from the time. She fled Russia and was the last of the Romanovs to escape the country in 1920. However, her jewels, including the precious tiara, were hidden before then when she was placed under house arrest in 1917. Mary's son and his British art dealer friend daringly saved the jewels by posing as workmen and sneaking them out of the former palace in 1920. When they reached London, Queen Mary, Queen Elizabeth's grandmother, bought the tiara with its pearls and it sent for much needed repairs. The emeralds, which can be suspended in the loops of the tiara, come from the Cambridge emeralds. The Duchess of Cambridge, Queen Mary's grandmother, owned the emeralds and they were inherited by her son, Mary's brother. However, when he beheaded the emeralds to his mistress, Queen Mary paid a handsome sum to buy them back in order to keep the heirloom jewels in the family. Queen Mary can be seen wearing the Kokoschnik with pearls in her portrait for her husband George Silver Jubilee. Queen Elizabeth has worn the Vladimir Kokoschnik with both the pearl and emerald options. The last time was in 2014, when she chose to wear the green emeralds to honor the state visit of the Irish president. In the end, Meghan chose Queen's Mary Diamond Bandeau, a beautiful piece that had not been seen in public for over 50 years until the Duke and Duchess of Sussex royal wedding. And that's all in today's news. Thank you for watching this video. Hit the like button, subscribe the channel, and I'll see you next time. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.